गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न कोहेरेंट डिटेक्शन ऑफ DSP-AC. इन द लास्ट टू क्लासेस वी हैव डिस्कस अबाउट द मॉड्यूलेशन प्रोसेस ऑफ DSP-AC एंड टुडे वी डिस्कस अबाउट द डीमॉड्यूलेशन प्रोसेस ऑफ द DSP-AC. सो व्हाट इज डीमॉड्यूलेशन? डीमॉड्यूलेशन इज द प्रोसेस दैट इज यूज टू रिकवर the original signal from the modulated signal. And here the name given as coherent detection. Coherent means synchronous detection. In synchronous detection, the carrier signal used in the transmitter section and the carrier signal used in the receiver section are same in phase and frequency, then that is known as synchronous. So first we draw the block diagram of demodulator section. So the block diagram of coherent detector is consist of three blocks, that is multiplier, low pass filter and local oscillator. So to the multiplier we give two inputs. One of the input is the modulated signal, that is transmitted by the transmitter section and received by the receiver section. This demodulator section is the receiver section. So that signal is received by the receiver section and given to the multiplier. And to the another input, a locally generated carrier is given, means the local oscillator is used to generate a carrier signal, that is C(T) equal to cos omega CT. So when the carrier signal used in the transmitter section is same as the carrier signal used in the receiver section, or we can say it should be similar to the carrier of the transmitter section. Which parameters are to be similar? That is phase and frequency. Then it is known as synchronous or coherent detection. So when we give the two input to the multiplier, it simply multiplies the signal. So here we get M(T) into C(T). Okay, then the signal passed through the low pass filter and at the output we get X(T). How? So for that, just we derive the equation that M(T) into C(T). So M(T) is the M(T) is the modulated signal. So modulated signal is the X(T) cos omega CT, that is generated by the transmitter section, into carrier signal, that is given here cos omega CT. So X(T) cos square omega CT. Then as we know the formula, cos square theta equal to 1 plus cos 2 theta by 2. We just put the formula here. So X(T) into 1 plus cos 2 omega CT by 2. Then X(T) by 2 plus x of t cos 2 omega c t. This one the signal that we get here means at the output of the multiplier we get this output. So when we pass this signal through the low pass filter, what happened? We just keep the cutoff frequency of low pass filter up to fm, or here we can say omega m. Here the cutoff frequency is omega m. Then when this signal is passed through the low pass filter, then at that time, as we know, x of t having the frequency component of omega m, and here the frequency component is 2 omega c plus minus omega m. So it only allow this term and reject this one. So at the output we get x of t by 2. That means x of t is the modulating signal and 1 by 2 is a DC value. Okay, so here we get x of t by 2. So this is the equation derived if there is no phase error, no frequency error. If any type of error present in the carrier signal, then what will be the equation? For example, if phase error occurs, then here we can write phi cos omega c t plus phi. This phi represent the phase error. Okay, then at that time what happened? Then just we multiply this two signal, that is m of t into c of t. M of t is the x of t cos omega c t into cos omega c t plus phi. Okay, then here we apply the formula of cos A into cos B. Okay, we know 1 by 2 cos A plus B plus cos A minus B. So we just apply this formula here. So x of t by 2 cos omega c t plus omega c t plus phi plus cos omega c t minus omega c t plus phi. After that, x of t by 2 cos omega c t plus omega c t means 2 omega c t, 2 omega c t plus phi, then plus cos omega c t minus omega c t minus phi. So omega c t cancelled out. So here we can write x of t by 2 cos 2 omega c t plus phi, and then plus x of t by 2 cos phi. This one is the equation that we get here. Then
we pass the signal through the low pass filter and the cutoff frequency of the low pass filter is omega m. So here the frequency is 2 omega c. If we solve this term, then we get 2 omega c plus minus omega m, and here we get only omega m. As cos phi is a, or we can write here theta also, okay. So cos phi is the constant term, so there is no frequency present. So here only the frequency term is omega m. So only low pass filter allow this term and reject this one. So if there is error, then also only the term having x of t is allowed by the low pass filter. But we have to ensure that phi always be at 0 degree, because if it is 0 degree, then we get a high amplitude signal at the output of the detector. If phi equal to 90 degree, then at the output we get 0, means no signal we get at the output. That effect is known as quadrature null effect. Null effect. Okay. This one is known as quadrature null effect. So we always ensure that the carrier signal of transmitter and receiver have phi equal to 0, means no phase error present in between them. Only then we get a high amplitude signal at the output. Otherwise, the amplitude decreases if the value is 10 degree, 15 degree, 20 degree, and gradually decreases. And if it is phi equal to 90 degree, then output will be 0, and that effect is known as quadrature null effect. So this is all about coherent detection of DSPAC. In the next class, we will discuss about the generation process of SSBAC. Thank you.